John 5:30 says, "I can do nothing on my own. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek not my own will, but the will of him who sent me." John 5:30. These are the words of Jesus, and if Jesus says that he can do nothing on his own, how much more can we not do anything on our own? Because the only thing that we as humans can do without the help of God is sin. But that's the very thing we want to distance ourselves from, because the flesh is flesh, and the flesh wants what the flesh wants, but we want the spiritual man to put on the spiritual things and to press into what God has for our lives and has revealed through scriptures, and what leads down the path of righteousness and holiness. And so if Jesus said that, we need to be willing to be humble enough to admit that we truly can do nothing worthwhile or worth doing without him. And as Jesus had said this, he said this in humility, and then he follows, he says, "As I hear, I judge." We cannot properly judge without hearing scripture and hearing from the voice of the Holy Spirit and taking time to spend with God. Because if we simply just judge in the fleshly sense, we're going to judge on the basis of being overly ambitious, comparing ourselves with one another, and being overly competitive. And this is the wrong sort of judgment. We want our judgments to be pure and perfect and to be done rightly. And that is done, especially when it comes to deceiving gospels, hypocritical Christians who think they're born again, but they're not, and they're not at all wanting to seek God or walk in their ways. But this can only be done if we stay in the Word and we hear from God the Father. Because if we don't hear from God, then how are we going to judge appropriately? And Corinthians tells us not to judge those outside the church, but those inside the church, because that's where the judgment starts. Judgment starts in the house of God. How much worse is it going to be for those outside of the house of God? So when we take time to hear from God, we can judge appropriately, not in a judgmental sense of pointing the finger, but in a discerning sense of seeing, okay, this is what someone is saying and doing. Is this lining up with what Scripture has to say? And so when we do that, then our judgment is just like Christ, because it's the Holy Spirit speaking that wisdom in and through us and revealing to us the discernment that is needed to be able to properly judge. And so may we follow in the light of Christ to want to hear from God and to be willing to humble ourselves and truly admit that we can do nothing without him, because it is by him alone that we have life and that we can know truth and that we can truly love other people. And so may we continue to press on in the faith with all humility, but taking time to hear from the Lord. And when we do this, we are showing God that we don't want to fulfill our will, but we want to fulfill his. And when our heart is set and our mind is set and our soul is set on fulfilling the Father's will, then we place ourselves in the proper position to be able to receive and hear from God appropriately and to do everything with proper motives and intent. Because if we want our will to be fulfilled, we're going to be very selfish, we're going to do things wrongly, and we're going to corrupt that which is good. But when we seek the Father's will, we set aside our dreams and ambitions and we press into what he has for us, which is good and is part of his perfect plan, and it counts for eternity. It doesn't just count in this temporal life, it counts for eternity, and that it comes with suffering, persecution, trials, tribulation, adversity, blessings, joyful times, happy times, times of dancing. Everything that is done in the Father's will happens because we had at first wanted to press into his will, and when we desire to do his will, he'll reveal his will to us, and then we'll be able to endure anything and everything because we'll have our eyes gazed upon eternity and on the things above rather than the things on this earth. So may we humble ourselves, seek the will of God, seek to hear from him, and then may we be properly led by the Holy Spirit to pursue down the path of holiness and righteousness to complete and fulfill the will that the Heavenly Father has for us in this life.